The M2 MacBook Air will be coming out any week now, or is already out if you are watching this in the future. If you are looking to buy one, what are the best accessories that you can build around it to get the best experience? Let's find out. And while we're finding out, I'd like to thank today's sponsor, Squarespace. Okay, first off, you're gonna need a way to carry your laptop around. Nobody likes just hand-holding the laptop by itself. For that, I recommend my handy dandy trusty Lenovo backpack. The best thing about accessories is you don't have to buy new ones every time a new laptop comes out. Accessories last longer than the products themselves, which is why I've been recommending this backpack for about 2 years now. I was really nervous when I first started recommending this that maybe it would have a problem with longevity. Like maybe because it was a cheaper backpack, you would have problems with build quality or would fall apart after a while. I've taken this backpack all over the country now, and it looks exactly like I did when I first bought it. I love this backpack. It's super comfortable, has very comfy plush shoulder pads. It's svelte, it's sleek. The stitch work is fantastic. The zippers, while not my zipper snob favorite YKK or high-end zippers, they're good enough. Listen to this. They've got a good bite. I've never had a miss, you know, when you mangle the teeth of zippers because you bought cheap zippers. I've never had that issue. I use this backpack over, I've got very expensive like camera bag, laptop bag, stuff like that. I never use them because I'm always using this. The main reason to buy an unassuming backpack is so that people aren't like, I bet that backpack has a brand new MacBook in it that we should snag. I love this thing, highly recommend it, and I will continue to recommend this because it is the best. Next up, one of the problems with the MacBooks is they have lower storage capacity. You can get up to 2 terabytes, but some people may need more than that, or maybe you don't want to spend Apple's pretty steep markup for external storage. You could always get something like a solid state drive. Now, I have stopped recommending regular spinning hard drives unless you need like huge bulk storage, but if you don't need huge bulk storage if you're traveling and walking around. So I would say get a solid state drive. It'll give you a lot more things you can do with your MacBook, whether you're transferring files. I've had it where I've got a client or boss or leadership or something, they need the files from my computer, doesn't have SD card or like CD-ROMs. Do people still use CD-ROMs? You can just pop the files onto here, hand them over to somebody if you don't want to email them or use whatever kind of network. Maybe you can't connect to a client's network. Sometimes, yes, you can send files. Files can be bigger than some email clients or services will allow. That's where a solid state drive helps out. Or if you're a video creator or some kind of a creative, it is always nice to back up your files. You never only want to have one copy of a file, because if you have one copy, you really don't have any, because you're only a failure away from losing everything. I always will recommend some kind of a solid state drive. The T5 is the old standard. It's a little cheaper, reads and writes a little slower, but it's a solid state drive. It still reads and writes faster than anything a spinning drive could do. The T7 is the new one, which I did not grab. I grabbed 2 T5s. And this is a RavPower one. I don't think RavPower is still a company. Is RavPower still a company? Let me know in the comments below. If not, RavPower. I like this one because it's just so small. You could literally put this like even in a coat pocket. Like, it's great. Next up, I'm not gonna recommend a keyboard if you're traveling, but I am gonna recommend a mouse. We haven't recommended the Apple Magic Mouse in a while, but I've been using mine a lot again recently, as I really like how you get the gestures of a trackpad on this mouse. It's a little more expensive, and yes, charging it is the dumbest design of a mouse ever. But if you're looking for portability and a lot of functionality, it's hard to go wrong here. The battery charge lasts a very long time. Again, it's very rare to find a mouse that will let you scroll vertically, but also laterally, like horizontally. That is really hard to do. It makes this incredibly versatile. You could also buy a smaller Logitech like Pebble, something like that, but that's only gonna give you regular mice capabilities. It's a great mouse and I've recommended it here in the past, but you're buying the Air, you're traveling for work, you do need some kind of a mouse. I think this is a fantastic addition to a MacBook. Then you have a MacBook, you've got 2 Thunderbolt 3 ports, which means you don't got a lot of other kind of versatility, so you are gonna need some kind of a dongle. Now, docks we'll talk about in a second, but a dongle is almost a requirement if you are gonna be buying a MacBook, especially not one of the MacBook Pro 14s or 16s. I like this little dongle from Anker. It gives you USB-A, USB-A, HDMI, and Ethernet. That's really, if you're looking for what you need on the move, that's pretty much it. If I'm on the move, I may need to plug in a presentation pointer, you get USB-A. I may need to plug into a client's monitor, HDMI, and maybe there's a client that doesn't have Wi-Fi in 2022 and they only have a physical connection. There you go, Ethernet. This one is pretty much essentially everything you could ever need. It's small, fits anywhere. I'm not the biggest fan of dongles. I personally use a MacBook Pro 16 for this point, but for a MacBook Air, you kind of got to use something like this. And if you're a YouTuber or a photographer or somebody and you absolutely need SD card, then I would recommend getting the Apple standard USB-C to SD card adapter. It's hard to go wrong here. One of the things I'll find with recordable media when I'm trying to use a MacBook is it gets warm, so I would always recommend first party accessories. Another thing you're probably going to need is your screen's going to get dirty. Every screen gets dirty. Even if it's shut somehow, my screen gets dirty. I don't understand how that works. Get some microfiber cloths. You don't need anything fancy. I think you can get a huge pack of these on Amazon for just a few bucks, but it will help you so much. Instead of using your hands to wipe off something or like a paper towel, just the thought of that grosses me out. Save me from having to think about it, some hassle. Give yourself some peace of mind. Get some microfiber cloths because they will save your booty so many times just being able to clean off your screen. And then the last couple of things, I should have mentioned this a second ago with the dongle, but I don't really consider these a dongle. I consider these like an emergency, like save your butt scenario. These are USB-C to USB-A adapters. These are not only for you, though they very easily fit into a MacBook and will give you USB-A for that PowerPoint clicker or for that keyboard you want to plug in. But these are for you or for your coworkers. I have loaned these to people so often, they may not know there are different kinds of connections, or maybe they forgot theirs. And these are just so easy to, you could just put these in your pocket, you could put these in your wallet. You just carry these around and save everybody. These are a life accessory, not necessarily a MacBook accessory. I would recommend some kind of a different charging adapter. Yes, the M2 MacBook Air comes with that dual charger. However, dual charger, even though it's new for Apple, is still kind of behind the curve. I would recommend getting some kind of a multi-charge adapter. The one that I really recommend, I can't hold in my hand right now because it's powering a lot of the things that you're seeing, but I will put some B-roll of it over here. But you can get any kind, there are so many smart chargers, fast chargers, USB-C, USB-A, that will either have a separate cable, they themselves will plug into the wall, whatever. Get something like that so you can charge your MacBook and your iPhone at the same time. You could charge your iPhone off of your MacBook, but I don't really like doing that. You don't really need a charger. You'll notice that there are no external batteries here because the M2 and the M1 MacBooks have fantastic battery life, but I like having external chargers just in case. Thanks to today's sponsor, Squarespace, you can create your own very beautiful website. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a professional website, online store, or portfolio. It's easy to claim a domain / URL, create a custom site that matches your style, and bring your ideas to life. Head on over to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, head over to squarespace.com/everydaydad to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. But now you're back at your home office and you want to set up your MacBook Air to be your only computer. What are some accessories that I would recommend for that? Well, that's too easy. Thank you for asking, team. First off, if you're going to be working from home, you need to decide, are you going to set up a desk or are you just going to use the laptop as a laptop? If you're just going to use the laptop as a laptop, see what we've already talked about. But if you are going to set it up at a desk, you need a couple of things first. One, you need some kind of a stand. Now, I personally keep my MacBook in clamshell mode when I'm using it, so I will use something like this. This is the Book Arc from 12 South. I think they still make these. It works with all of the MacBooks I've ever used. I think technically it's only for like MacBook Pro 13s and MacBook Airs, but I've used this with my MacBook Pro 16. It's fantastic. The MacBook just sits in there, boom, holds it, and then you can plug it into the rest of the stuff that I'm talking about. However, my wife prefers working with her laptop open. For that, you would need some kind of a stand like this from Design. All this does is it holds it so it sits down, and then you can set it at whatever angle you want. Now, if you are gonna be using the laptop by itself, I would also recommend this because it will then put it at your desk where it's up, back, away from you. The screen's more ergonomically level so you're not hunched over a laptop all day long because that is real bad for you. So something either like the Arc, which lets you use it in clamshell mode, or this Design, which lets you use it in regular laptop mode. Then if you are gonna have it set up to a bunch of different things, you need a monitor. This is my monitor. I do not recommend this. It's way too expensive. Just get some kind, if you're working, it doesn't matter. Just get some kind of a monitor that fits your size, resolution requirements. You don't need to spend a lot of money on a monitor. Don't fall for the trap that I fell in thinking you need OLED. You do not need OLED if you're working from home. Next, I will recommend a dock for a working from home situation because you will probably need a lot more professional ports, or you'll just want something that you can easily plug in once and be done with it instead of always having to plug in the dongle and out, stuff like that. So I use this OWC Thunderbolt 3 dock. I believe they have a Thunderbolt 4 version out now too, but the MacBook Air, even the M2 version, will only use Thunderbolt 3. This will give you a lot of really cool things. It gives you micro SD card, SD card headphone, high power USB, USB-C on the front. I mean, all of this stuff, that's what I like, is I like having I.O. that's on the front of a computer. That's why I like the Mac Studio so much. But if you're using a MacBook Air, this will also give you a lot of USB-A. It'll give you Ethernet, USB-C, even a DisplayPort, that older version of DisplayPort, and it is powered. And all of this, it is more expensive, but if you're gonna have a home setup, you've gotta have some kind of a dock. Then if you're gonna be working from home and in a dock mode, you'll need a mouse and a keyboard. So I, at the home, the Logitech MX Master 3 is the best mouse I've ever used in my life. You can tell it is getting gross. I've had this one for a couple years at this point, so if you're looking for longevity of the plastic or the rubber will never wear out, well, this took a couple of years, but it is definitely starting to get gross now. The Apple Magic Mouse has never gotten gross or worn out on me. However, this has lateral scroll, it has customizable functions, and the best part, it has USB-C in the front, so you can have this plugged in and charging and use it at the same time. What kind of space age technology design language is that? Then for keyboards, I have kind of turned into a mechanical keyboard fan. Now, you don't need to spend a lot of money to get a good functional mechanical keyboard. This is mine, this is more expensive, but it types great, it feels great. It's not that horrible click that you're used to when you think of mechanical keyboards, but you could also, this is something that I built for around 75 bucks. Doesn't sound very clicky. It's very comfortable to type on. You don't need a lot of work or experience to get something like this functional. All you do is you put all the pieces together. It's great. You don't have to spend a lot of money and you can get a very comfortable, very satisfying to work on keyboard. If you don't want something like that and you want more of a standard membrane Bluetooth keyboard, the Logitech MX Keys is another fantastic option. This will give you all of the keys. It will work with the same Logitech unifying receiver as your MX Master 3. That's actually how I have mine working right now. Can you see this switch right here? I've got the one receiver plugged into that switch. So whenever I use my KVM switcher, it will with whatever computer I've got plugged in. This is a fantastic keyboard. I really like it, but I'm kind of a mechanical keyboard snob at this point. Also, I highly recommend getting some kind of a wrist rest. If you're gonna be working from home, if you're gonna have your MacBook Air set up in a desk situation, you don't wanna hurt yourself as you're doing this. So I like having a wrist rest. Lets me set my wrist and just be able to ergonomically type. I do not recommend you try to get yourself hurt doing any of this stuff where you're in some kind of a crazy uncomfortable position. So just spend a little bit of money. This is not even from this. This is from like an old Logitech keyboard of mine. We talked about the KVM switcher. That is also something that I would recommend. If you have multiple computers, maybe you are somebody like me that switches between a PC and my Mac. If you are not, don't worry about that. The last thing I'm gonna recommend today, because it's not all about work, sometimes you gotta have some fun too. The cool thing about MacBooks these days is they work with all major console controllers. So if you wanna play a game, I know MacBooks aren't necessarily the best for gaming, but a lot of indie games and a lot of older games that still run on MacBooks, they don't need cutting edge AAA graphics. So I play a lot of old school games on my Mac and it works really well to have a controller that you can just pair and start having fun with. And the best part is you don't even have to buy one of these if you have these at your house. I didn't buy this for this video. This is just my PlayStation 5 controller. You can use it with Xbox too. It's really great. You should absolutely do that because you gotta have some fun. It's not all about spreadsheets or video editing and all that stuff. Have fun too. And if you like this video, click here to see my recommendation on which M2 MacBook Air you should buy. Click. Click, 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 click. Thanks for watching.